I announced that there will be three parts, three main topics in this channel. First, business plan for a business owner. Second, business plan for an investor. Third, structure and management of the business. I already explained all of it in basics, which is enough for the general understanding and starting a business. Of course, there can be many more details and situations, but as I said, I didn't plan to entertain you. All they explained before is what usually entrepreneurs don't like very much. They recognize it as a necessary evil, which they sometimes are afraid of, which is a boring part of a business and an unpleasant obligation. However, all of it can be very useful and valuable and not so boring as it looks, if to use it properly. So, now I will explain the additional part 4, which is exactly about this. In this part, I will explain things which I didn't see anywhere on the internet. For visualization of my explanations, I will use already known to you heroes and an existing business. Let's think that you plan to start a new business. What you will have to take into account and what you have to do. If you are alone, it is easy, and we already have spoken about. If you are not alone, it is in this business. The first things that you have to do, it is to make the agreement between partners. The importance of this we have also discussed. Partners have decided to name this agreement Agreement of Investments. They did it like this because the main part always in a business is about any kind of investments. So, such name for this document would be fair. The next point is who agreed with whom. As we know, partners will sign the agreement with each other. In the present case, the first step by the partners was to create the new legal entity, which is the core of the corporation as a form of the business. Then each partner signed similar agreement with this new legal entity. So, in this way, every partner has equal right and they created the legal entity which will be at fault now for everything if the business does not succeed. The parties decided to make a template of the agreement of investment to be used in future for any new partners who will participate as an investor. This allows to avoid legal fees every time when a new investor should appear. The next investor can sign this without addressing it with a lawyer because everything is written straightforward and has already been tested. If he wishes, he can go to his lawyer, but it would be wasting his time and money because the document is written clearly and using simple language understood to everyone. The present template of the document is intended to save time and money. However, it must be done according to law because there could be a situation when it would be present in a court of law. The purpose of the document is the guidelines for daily business operations, regulations between the signatories and the defense from each other. The defense in this case means your responsibilities for your own steps, not for steps made by other partners. So, you can sleep well. This is nothing to be afraid of, except your own stupidity. You have to watch out for only yourself, not for the others. These documents is the constitution of the business. Usually agreements between partners are pretty long documents with many details, some of which can be changed during the development of the business. In this case, it was decided by all that not very important or changing directions would be to publish updates on the internal password-protected company's website. This modern way allows partners to monitor changes that are happening in the corporation at any convenient time. This internal information website was decided to be called the company's online office. Such a name reflected the modern reality when the business participants were located far away from each other. And during the startup period, there was no need to rent an office, and mostly all the work could be done at home. In many cases, they do live in different countries and plan to stay there, even if the business would be successful. In those cases, an online office as a place for communicating is the only possible solution. In the agreement is written the terms of use of the online office. By law, any shareholder holding even just one share has a right to receive a complete report about business activity and the financial results. However, practically, the financial results are only available at the annual meeting of the shareholders. Depending on the corporation, administration decision result can be provided at other times. The online office allows monitoring activities of the corporation practically in the real time, which allows shareholders to actively participate in the process. However, the full access to this information can put the company at risk of its secrets being leaked. As I mentioned before, speculators are enemies of a small business. They penetrate in the company only with one purpose – to monitor the internal company financial information and to wait and make their investments right before the company reaches success, which is not just useless for the company, but directly unprofitable for other shareholders. In addition to this, speculators can deliberately share the internal company's information to a potential competitor. According to their sneaky plans, they can distribute rumors, etc. Later, it will be difficult to figure out who exactly did the damage. If you forgot my previous explanation about speculators, you should watch the first part of this video course again. I had the personal experience of when the speculator, pretending to be an investor, offered his help to act as a company representative at a meeting with a new potential investor. This investor informed me that he was shocked, disappointed, and rejected our proposal because the authorized representative of the company recommended to him to invest into another business which had nothing close to his investment interests. It was unknown what the idea was in the speculator's head, but by one move he made serious damage to the promising new company and broke the trust of the person and to the entire startup business. To avoid such negative situations and cut out speculators, it was decided to allow access to the online office only to investors who already took the risk by investing an amount of over $20,000. Losing such an amount is sensitive enough if you have come only for inside information. To make damage, the initiator of the trouble risks to lose this amount. This was made to stop speculators who wish to buy the cheapest tickets for monitoring only. The amount of $20,000 was a security deposit in exchange for the information, but also gave them voting rights and co-ownership. Maybe you think that I'm speaking too much about speculators relatively to a small business, because usually this term, speculators, is related to the stock market. Practice show that speculators are in small and large business and in the stock market. The problem is that speculators often don't know that they are speculators. They call themselves investors, and they don't have any special negative plans. They simply wish to make money, which is quite all right. One person, known by me personally, who had worked hard his entire life, dreamed that his already adult son would become a businessman. He gave to him $100,000 of his savings. Soon after, he found out that his son was officially bankrupt. The son, instead of opening his own business, purchased shares of public companies on the stock market and lost everything. With intent to fix the situation, he took a bank loan and purchased new public shares. And finally, he also became bankrupt. The person who doesn't care what is going on in the business, where he is investing, and who doesn't see the difference between a business and a casino, is not an investor. He is a speculator or gambler. In this case, it was both the father and the son. Nothing is wrong with speculation of the stock market, but it is totally wrong regarding small business. Who you want to be, an investor or a speculator, cannot be spontaneous. We always have to make a conscious, truthful decision, not only in business. After watching this video course, you will not make such a mistake. Unfortunately, speculators are not only cash investors. I saw a situation when one of her partners of a new business asked for only 2% ownership for himself. I personally didn't understand why I would only ask for 2%, because it is simply too little for, from any point of view, for wasting my time. What logical explanation could be there? There is definitely a hidden agenda which is unknown to the other partners. This partner has something on his mind and is preparing for a smart move. What is it? And against whom? Does it mean that one partner is not honest with the others? How can a partnership start out like this? If he is questioned by anyone, he can answer that it is not their business, because he hasn't violated their rights, and he would be right. Would such comments fully satisfy you? Every person has his own smart plan and doesn't like to share it with others. If other partners don't ask for more than 2% ownership, it is good for me. I will have more. We all love to count one's chickens before they are hatched. However, later, when only one of the partners will become successful, not many of us will say, "I was stupid." Most of us will say, "I was deceived," or "I got screwed." The method which I explain here will allow you to concentrate on the business idea and not thinking about issues with partners who maybe are not honest with you, or that maybe you got caught in the speculation's net. It is really not easy to construct a hotel from scratch and then make it profitable. Due to the competitors, which are always around, such a business simply cannot be successful if the partners, instead of concentrating on the construction, will be busy with suspicions that somebody is playing dishonest games or damaging the business. However, you have to remember that the freedom from the negative influence and impact and the concentration on the business will be fully effective only if you will use this method from the beginning of the business. In this next paragraph of the agreement, it is mentioned Class A and Class B shares. I will explain this when we will reach the paragraph shares. The paragraph Common Rules is actually the beginning of the core of the agreement, which doesn't require any additional explanation. In the paragraph Obligations of Parties, in the part Obligation of the Corporation, everything is straightforward. Actually, if you don't know what to write in the agreement which you are preparing for your business, you can simply copy this one. You can stop the video, make a screenshot, and simply rewrite the text. Read it carefully and make sure that it is all right for you. Don't blame me for that. I'm not giving you the link to the blank document template. I didn't promise you to make you rich. My goal is to make you think. You already know the basics. Now we're speaking about the art. You will understand better if you at least write the entire text of the agreement instead of just filling the empty spots of a blank document. The paragraph Obligation of the Parties in the part The Investor Undertakes contains more important and not so standard obligations. For example, to invest or loan with no interest and do not demand an immediate payment or return of his or her loan. To not sell and or transfer his or her shares to another investors or third party without the prior written consent of the corporation. To provide the company with a time report of his or her loan with no interest for working hours or expenses related to the corporation's projects. The investors further recognize that failure to provide such a report shall release the corporation from any responsibility to reimburse such expenses or work. Party decided that the corporation would pay to any shareholder for any work that he or she will do. However, it is the obligation of the shareholder to inform the corporation in written form. If he will not do this, it will mean that the payment is not required from the corporation. The shareholder has to present some form of invoice. Without this, something could be missed or miscalculated. So, it is the responsibility of shareholder to report. It is obvious that such report or invoice has to be checked and approved in some way. But also, any startup usually has a shortage of cash and payment is simply impossible. How to resolve such a situation? If the shareholder agrees, he could credit the corporation by the loan with no interest, as written in the agreement of investment, what means not collecting compensation for his made work and wait to the moment when cash will arrive in the corporation from cash investor or the corporation revenue. When the corporation will have the ability to pay, then he will receive his compensation. Alternatively, and according to the present agreement of investment, he can ask compensation immediately by receiving corporate shares on the amount present in his report invoice. In this case, the corporation pays for his work using its shares as a cash and the share certificates as a banknotes. The choice to make a credit, meaning loan with no interest, or to receive shares totally belongs to the shareholder. In both cases, he/she takes a risk, never receive compensation. because it will be positive, possible only if the business will be developing positively. Otherwise, any credits as well as shares will simply disappear together with the corporation. Therefore, if the shareholder wishes to increase his influence in the corporation, he will choose the receiving of additional shares because they increase his voting power right now. And additionally, in the case of success, the dividends will also be increased. It would be illogical if anyone will prefer passive waiting for a potential instead of utilization of his right to increase personal potential. However, practice shows that sometimes it is happening, and the reason for that is an ignorance and absence of a common sense. Thank you. Class dismissed. Next time I will talk about topics which you see on the screen. See you soon.